To start insert learning, from Google search bar, we have to search for insert learning and typing insertlearning.com and click enter. Now you will find this site. From here, you can add this insert learning to your Google Chrome bar. As it is a web tool, you can add this as add on the Chrome bar, right? Google Chrome, it's a free only for certain time. After that, it will be asking for a subscription, $8 per month or around $40 or $45 per year annual subscription. So it is already inserted. Now I am going to use this IL. Going to Google browse bar. I want to prepare a material or notes for my class. I am visiting some site. Okay, I am going to Wikipedia. This is a site. I want to get some information for my class. Right. So after coming to the website, now you can click on the IL. Once you are clicking IL, you can find the insert learning toolbar coming onto your web page. Now it is asking sign in with Google. I can say sign in with Google. Now I am selecting the teacher. See, this is the IL toolbar, right? How we can use these? The insert toolbar is ready. Now I am browsing the selected website. You can go for any website, no issues. You see, even if you are selecting one more, I want to select some digital marketing. I want to find some information regarding digital marketing. I am going to this one blog. In this blog, I am selecting a blog. The blog is being loaded. After loaded, you can get this IL to your website, right? Web page. Right. So after loading that website, after loading that blog, you can bring this IL to your web page. You just click on that. You can notice the insert learning toolbar has come to your web page. Now you can concentrate your site wherever you want to make any notes. You can do that. You see, I am selecting this. I want to highlight this. Highlight this paragraph. Then go to the highlight bar, highlight tool. It will be automatically will be getting highlighted. Yes, I did not complete. No. So this is assigned. Once you completed all your assignments, all your notes preparation, you want to assign to your students. By that time, we can make use of the. By that time, we can make use of this IL icon assign. So this one is for highlighting wherever you want to highlight, or if you want to highlight with some other color, you can do that. Clear. So this is how we can make use of the highlight. This one is a sticky note. By using this sticky note, you can give some the comments on some paragraph, or you can insert some videos, or you want to insert some images. So the sticky note is just you are giving some information related to that particular selected paragraph or sentences, right? So this one is a question. In between, after reading some paragraph, you want to ask some questions. You can assign some marks also. The graded also can be done. You can ask some question, true or false, or some other. You can ask the students to write relevant to that paragraph. Start a discussion forum. For example, after reading this paragraph, you want to talk about the students. You want to start a discussion on research. So, in the topic of research, you can start a discussion forum. All the your students also can add their points, or you too can add their points. You can discuss on the particular topic. Right, so this is the more option that we will see one by one later, how we can assign, how we can welcome, how we can share this content to our fellow faculties, all these things. Okay, so after assigning this, after preparing this material, you want to test, you want to have a preview kind of, you want to have a preview. By the time you can make use of, there is a view as a student, right? So you can take the printout, or we can go to the dashboard. So these are the remaining options we can have by clicking the three dots, right? So at any point of instance, you can have the help and support by using this icon, right? Now I want to change this you go to the brush, you change the colors, or you want to add some more the tooltip or some prompting information, read this and try to understand. Read this and try to understand. So this is the information you want to add with the highlighted. Now we can say okay. So you see, whenever the student the clicking this highlighted area, they can see this the prompting message also. Along with the message, if you want to add some symbols, expressions, that also possible. You can have any information, any the sticky note. See, I want to add this, okay? Or still you want to see some other, you want to give some flags. See, many more symbols also is there. You can select any one of them. You can click on that. See, you added some prompting message, at the same time some icons also added. So this is how we can add the highlighting to the content. Still we are on the website, the web page only. Now I want to find, I am finding this information is quite interesting. So here I want to give some sticky note. You click this, you select the paragraph. Now you can type this, read and find read and find the meaning of this idea. We'll discuss in our class. Okay, so this is what we want to give the information to the students by reading this paragraph. So in this place, if you want to add any video, you can click on this. The audio will be captured, your laptop camera will be getting on, that will be recording you directly. So your record also will be recorded. Don't want, if you want to retake by using the red button, you can once again read it. You see, I am taking retake. Now click on the button. Once again, you can talk to your students. So second time, fine-tuned version, you can record it and click it at the end. You can click this icon. Now click on the button. One, and if you want to use this video. So this taken video will be embedded in your sticky note. And one more thing. So here we can say, here we can see, insert a question. I want to ask one question. You just click this question and select the paragraph on which paragraph, based on which paragraph we want to push a question. So this is the template it is giving. You can create a question. For creating questions also, this IL giving some options. See, you can write this ERP, you know. Digital marketing is really helpful to business people, right? So here you can give one more option, not at all helping the customers. Okay, and we are typing the second one. See, option one and option two. And if you want to edit this, you can say how much mark you want to give. I want to give 5 marks. Then you can say save. See, this is a question I prepared. Based on the question chosen answer, I can give you the marks. How extent the students are understanding, I can check by giving opportunity to read the information in the web page information, web page paragraph, and instantly we can ask the questions, right? And so this is how we can make use of the insert questions. And this one is a discussion forum. So what are the discussion forum? You just click this, and here I want to add one discussion forum based on this paragraph. So what would be the discussion forum? Digital marketing is trending nowadays. So trending nowadays. So this is the topic I started. Okay, I'm creating. By clicking the creating, we can create that. So what is your response? You can add your response. Yes, slowly it is coming up. Okay, so this is your comment on this discussion. Now if you want to post this, you can simply say post, it will be posted, updated. See, you started the topic, digital marketing is trending nowadays, and you have added some comment. Yes, slowly it is coming up. Now this also the part of your web page. Now if you are sharing this web page to your students, the students also can able to see this discussion forum. They also able to add their comment in this discussion forum. It will be continuous, right? So we can notice the students are involving in this discussion forum, how many students are involved, and their timestamp, all those things. See, my timestamp also given like that, by what time they visited this website and how they are doing. It is a kind of monitoring the student's performance, right? Interaction. So this is how we can make use of this one. Now I am going back to, and here one more three buttons are there, three dots. You can click on this. You can assign to the students. So this website web page I want assign to my students as a homework, otherwise material to my students. By clicking this, we can do that, right? Or if you feel this, the notes, prepared notes is very good, you want to share with your fellow faculties, fellow teachers, you can use this. By clicking this, you can add them, or you can, you see, by clicking this, the link will be created. This link you can copy, you can send to your, you can share with your fellow teachers by Facebook or Twitter or by mail or even WhatsApp or Telegram. So any way media you can share it. And a few more information also is there. You want to test this. I want to test this created notes as a student. By the time you can click on this, you see, I want to see this, how it looks like when my students are entering into my prepared page. You see, did you notice that the IL on the toolbar coming only with the two, but previously we used as a faculty, we have got four tools, but for other students, they will be able to see only two icons. Of course, they can see the more option. In that more option also, only dashboard only available. Okay, right. So if I'm browsing down, I should be able to see that, no? You see, this is a highlighted one done by me. If I'm clicking these, they'll be able to see the prompt message, which I have given at the time of the preparing, the underline that, right? Now, if I'm coming down, they are able to see this one. It's a highlighted, the one more. So this one is also there. They can see what is your question. Digital marketing is really helpful for the business. So they are checking this. They want to check this one. This also they can. So only one option, no? A and B, they have taken this one. You come down. Here we can see the discussion forum. Now, as a student, if they wanted to add some comment or they want to involve in this discussion forum, they too can give their information. They too can post their comments on this, right? So after this, they can post this. That also will be updated. See, timestamp also added. So this is how we can see this one. If the student wanted to add some sticky note in the lesson, because these are available, no? The student want to highlight this one. He wanted to highlight this sentence, and they can click this. See, the student added this. By clicking this, yes sir, this is very interesting, right? If they want add some symbols, they can add some expressions also, right? So next one, if the student wanted to add some sticky note, yes, they too can add a sticky note on some question. See, they can add, please throw some light on these two, sir. Okay, so he is giving like this, and we want to resume to teacher's view. Now we are in the teacher's mode. This is the way we can make use of this insert learning toolbars. Okay, now we are going to enter into insert learning website. I am clicking on this IL so that I will be getting this screen. Now I have to log in to my account. Just by clicking that, we can select our account, and before getting to that, some option it is asking which best describes your role. I am a teacher, so you can select the teacher, and what subject do you teach? You can select this one. And which course you are, which grade you are teaching. I am teaching 13th place, and you can submit that. So this is the basic information we are giving to the IL. Now I am in my insert learning page. Now we can see the new lesson can be created. Here before that we will try to understand the menu bar. The one is lesson, another one is the grades, and the classes, public library, and the resources. So these are the labels, or these are the menus available by default, right? For that we will try to understand how the IL, the console is. Now we can click on the lesson, or we can go to the grades. So before going to that, we can say name of the folder. You can create the name of the folder, Kalyan. New is the folder name, right? So the IL is giving us make use of the folders so that we can organize our lessons in a good way. And a subject also we can mention. You can mention your subject, maths or science, whatever it is, you can mention the subject and level, second standard or 10th standard, that is up to you. You can specify that. And tags, if you have any tags, if you want to give any tags, you can do that. List in public library. Right now, I don't want to give it to public library. So this is meaning that what are the notes you are preparing? If you are checking this box, your prepared material will be listed in the public library that can be visible to anybody from the globe. Like that. So if you are checking that, your notes will be available to rest of the world. Okay. So these are the information I have given. Just I am saying okay. Now see, we can able to see a folder, new folder. So this folder, you can keep some information within this folder that can be assigned to your class, right? Now click this folder. So this is a folder, the folder is empty. You can come back by clicking this icon, right? Now I am just looking at the classes, the new class. So before going to assign, if you want to create a class, you can come to the classes, you can create the new class. The new class can be created. After creating the class, assign the lessons to it, then give class code to the supporters, to the students. So first create a class and assign the lesson, then give it and give its class code to the students. It's the same way, the class code, if you are creating class, a class code will be generated. That class code can be shared with our students using this class code. The students can enter into our class, right? Shall we create a new class? Right, we can create a new class. So this class can be created freshly. Otherwise, already existed class, Google class also you can select, that will be assigned to this one. If you want to create a new one, you can say create, I am giving name, the new Kalyan. Or subject is folder also given, no? Kalyan new. Okay, so I am creating one. See, this Kalyan new is a class has been created. This is a code generated. This is a code generated, right? So this code can be copied and you can share with your students. Using that code, they can come to this newly created course. Right now, there is no lessons, no students, only myself is present. So that's why only one teacher is showing. Here you can invite co-teachers to the same class, or you can edit information of this the class, or you can delete the class also. If you don't want to this class, you can delete this. So these are the options. By using this, you can create the new classes, right? Okay. Now we are going to create a lesson. The lesson already created. Once again, from this panel, we will try to create one lesson. You can create a new lesson. The new lesson can be created in the two ways. One is you can go to the website and you can click this IL and you can start create your lesson. The second one is you can find relevant, engaging content with our educated current search. That means the resources are there, no? The resources are public library. From the public library, you can get one lesson that can be modified, that can be copied. By the way, also we can create a lesson. So lessons can be created two way. One is what we made earlier, this one. Click the insert learning extension. Click the insert learning extension on any web page. So means you have to go to the web page, then you have to click on the IL. That already completed. Now you are going to see this one, search. So what we want to search? I want to search ICT. ICT, you click that. See, still we are in the IL only. So here, these are the internal search engine. So from internal inbuilt search engine also, we can do this, right? So if you find this one is very interesting, you can click this. Now we are in the new web page. So here also, that link has the tool, this IL, the insert learning toolbar has come. Now we can start creating your lessons. Convert this PDF into Google Doc. You can convert into Google Doc or view details about the instructions. So I think this is the only PDF form. So instead, we will go back and we'll try to select one more, the website. So this is a PDF. I'm selecting a website from internal resource. I'm coming to a website. And now I'm able to see the IL toolbar also. Now I can select this. I can highlight this, right? As usual, we can change the colors. As usual, we can go on, start creating our lessons. At the end, we can assign this, okay? More options, we can assign to the students. Now we can click on this assign. I created one class, new Kalyan. Kalyan new, you click that and you can say assign. Or you can go to the Microsoft team. Or you can use the links also, you can copy the link, you can go to some other places. We can invite the students to our class. Now I am selecting the created class, I am assigning. Okay, assigning has been done. Now I am going back to my dashboard. In the dashboard, I want to see the classes. See, one lesson has been added, isn't it? You click on that lesson, you can see Kalyan new classes. You click this TEDx, TED.com. So this is a site, no? So this lesson is added here. Now we can assign this to anybody else, or you can invite some other classes also. So once you created a lesson, that same lesson can be shared with other classes, different classes also. Different classes means you can create directly, or you can invite students from Google Classroom, or you can invite through Team, etc. Okay. Now, if you want to see the grades, so grades is nothing but you can already create a lesson with some questions, right? In that you inserted some questions, you ask the students to attend the questions. If any students attended, the marks can be graded. Marks can be graded. That marks you can see in the reports. You can create a report also. So that is how the grades is helping us. Okay. So this is the Kalyan new. I am selecting this, all students, all classes, and any questions So no question has given, so that is why we are not able to see that. So if you are given some questions at the same time, if any students attended that questions, here it will be reflecting so that we can grade it. Next one, class creation, already seen that. And this is the public library. So this public library is nothing but is a, and the resources from there we can get some already prepared information. See what area you want to search. So these are the, you see the browser very limited means this page is very very and the bigger one, the big one. Now which area you want to search? I want to search only ICT. What level I want to go with the 12th level. Any shared by any, if you know any faculty name or anybody else, very specifically you want to see the notes, backup. So like that, you can select information. It is taking some time. So instead we will do in a simple search. Okay. Okay, I want to search science. The next one, any level. I'm not giving any level, simply innovative research. Okay, innovative research, simple way. See, these are the things available. I want to select this photosynthesis. So this is the information. You see, they added some information here, right? The tooltip also given, and they mentioned that the annotation also given, the sticky pad also given, sticky note also given. In that they added some question, they added some video, right? So the video also added, and we can see the video.
This is Photosystem 1 and Photosystem 2 by Shane Mahoney. Right.
So if you want to add, you see the questions also given. If you are attending this, you need to copy this lesson first. So we need to copy the lesson first. You can copy the lesson, save it. So after saving, I can assign this to my students. You got it? So I went to some website that already created by other faculties, other teachers. I copied that and I modified that by adding some more information that can be assigned. You're coming back to your the site, you can see that lessons also, right? See, if you're able to see that lesson, that reflects here. Now this lesson can be assigned to your students. So this is how it is working. And resources is the next tab. You can find content, or you can Jabber tools and help center. So these are the other available things also available in the insert learning. So I hope you enjoyed this.